Michael Lonergan is my name. I'm the Deputy Irish Ambassador here in the Irish Embassy in Washington, D.C. There have been Irish people in Washington, D.C. since the very beginning. In fact, there are Irish people in Georgetown, which is the oldest part of Washington, which predates the city. When the Irish community came here in larger numbers, they settled in the area known as Swan Poodle, which is where modern-day Union Station is, near the U.S. Congress. Famous Irish people from the early parts of Washington, particularly centered around the figure of James Hoban, the architect who largely designed the White House in both its incarnations, the earlier White House and then the second rebuilding, the rebuilding after the British burnt it in the War of 1812. So the Irish have been here in Washington for a long time. And of course, for a long time, as President Kennedy liked to say, Washington DC was a town of northern charm and southern efficiency. This was a very small, largely southern town until the 1940s and really the impact of the Second World War, which turned Washington into a much, much larger and became the great city it is today. And this, of course, has seen a growth in the size of the Irish population here. Nothing akin to the size of our community in places like Boston and Chicago and New York, but nonetheless, there's a significant community here, and also, a significant community of Irish-born people who have come here to work, particularly in institutions which the city is full of, like the World Bank, the IMF, a large number of young Irish scientists working at the National Institutes of Health, Cancer Research, lecturing in universities, working in the large number of law and lobbying firms here. So we have an interesting combination of the older Irish communities descended from those who came in the post-famine period and the younger, newer Irish who have come. And one of the great advantages of the embassy is we're able to hold events where we bring the two strains together, if you like, the Irish-born, younger Irish here, and those descended from those who've made their home in the United States for, in some cases, over 150 years.